Hello, good evening from Medjugorje. Welcome to my prayer meeting, and let's just begin with a Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, come fill the hearts, come bring us in, come fill us with light, come with your glorious splendour, come in all your power. You are welcome here, Holy Spirit, you are welcome here, Holy Spirit. Come in your glory, come in your splendour, come with your might, come with your gentleness, come with your gifts, come with your charisms, and may I follow God's will through your guidance, and may you reveal to me what is God's will in this prayer meeting, and may you completely guide it, and may I surrender to your will, Lord, through the Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus, Amen. And it's Mother's Day, so happy Mother's Day to my mother, my earthly mother, and happy birthday or happy Mother's Day to Our Lady, who has been guiding me for this past 9 years on this incredible journey. And I want to dedicate this song to Our Lady and to my mother, who has helped me so much in my journey and who's promoted me, who's encouraged me, who's supported me, and who's been the backbone of this beautiful adventure with God. And welcome, Charlotte. Charlotte is a good friend from Belfast, and she's always supported me. And happy Mother's Day, Charlotte. And I'm going to sing a new song tonight. Fresh material. It's dedicated to Our Lady and my mum and all the mums out there. I've seen love come and I've seen love walk away. So many questions. Will anybody stay? It's been a hard year, so many nights in tears, all of the darkness trying to fight my fears. I've started breathing, the weight is lifted. Here with you, it's easy. My head is finally clear. There's nothing missing when you are by my side. I took the long road, but now I realize I'm home with you. I'm home. I don't know who I'd be if I didn't know you'd probably fall off the edge. I don't know where I'd go if you ever let go, so keep me held in your hand. I don't know who I'd be if I didn't know you'd probably fall off the edge. I don't know where I'd go if you ever let go, so keep me held in your hand. You're my safe place. my anchor, my saving grace. You're my constant, my steadiness. You're my shelter, my oxygen. I don't know who I'd be if I didn't know you. Thank God I do. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for sending us mothers. Thank you for sending us lights. Thank you for sending us Our Lady, who's appearing to the visionaries in Medjugorje. And thank you, Our Lady, for choosing me to be a beacon of light. And I want to pray for the mothers who are not with us tonight, who have departed, because there's people watching whose parents are no longer with them, but they're with them even more powerfully in the spirit through the heavenly realm. So let us pray for the dead mothers who've passed on and who've deceased. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. There's someone watching who hasn't let go of their mother properly. There's still an unhealthy attachment that Jesus wants to break. So whoever's watching, Jesus is going to touch you. He's going to touch you in your heart, and he's going to release that pain of false security, and he's going to release that tie, that human weakened tie that is a bondage, and he's going to break it in Jesus' name. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you for healing. Praise you for Jesus. Praise you, beautiful Jesus. Praise you, 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 Jesus. Because in my experience of life, when people, the healthy side of us that attaches to our earthly mothers, and in my experience that I was very attached to my Irish mother, but the journey that God's called me on, it's like I've got that earthly mother and I've attached my, okay, so we're back on air, something happened there. So I was trying to explain that we all have unhealthy attachments to our earthly parents, and especially in moments of bereavement it's hard to let go, but God wants us to be attached. So we ask God to release all those fears. Yeah, thanks, Charlotte. I know it's freezing, don't worry. I'll just keep going, but I'm not gonna, you didn't miss anything. So let's all release our healthy attachments that we have to our earthly parents and give them to God, and may he break the ties, and may those ties be attached to our spiritual mother who can look after us, and to remember that when mothers pass on, they're still with us and they can do even more things for us than they could when they were alive. I know that's hard to like believe, but through prayer and through a relationship with Our Lady, these attachments can be made healthy in Jesus' name. So let's sing another song. And I hope the technology doesn't freeze again, because it's never done that in a while. But in Bosnia, the Wi-Fi is a bit crap, so bear with me. And I feel God wants to like deliver us from all these attachments and all these worldly things that are conditioned on us. And he wants to bring us to a new place of attachment to him. Attachment to his ways, his will, the way he sees things. And he sees things so much better than we do. And since I've been called on this journey, I have noticed that. Bear with me. I'm in Medjugorje, a lot of graces are coming from Medjugorje through to the people that are watching, and I pray that this Mother's Day Our Lady will give you Mother's Day gifts, and she will help her with your needs, with your worries and your stresses. So we'll just say a decade of the rosary, and we'll pray Our Lady crowned Queen of Heaven, because she comes here as the Queen of Peace. So we'll offer up this mystery for the LGBT. Okay, there's a few technical problems, but we're back again on air. Okay, and we'll offer up this mystery for the LGBT who have been marginalised, misunderstood, and who need a pastoral path to be created within the church. And that's my dedication and my also for my mother on this Mother's Day. And if anybody else wants to add to the rosary or add any intentions, please feel free. Our Lady is crowned Queen of Heaven. Our Lady, you were crowned Queen of Heaven because you were so humble and you said yes. And your yes became your crown, and your crown was your humility, your crown was your obedience, and your crown was your selfless action as a Christian to serve God and only God. And may we all have that virtue and that dedication through the grace of Jesus. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I said that twice. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most in need of your mercy. Holy Michael the Archangel, defend us in the hour of battle, be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan, and with him all the evil spirits who wander through this world, seeking the ruin of souls. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal salvation, grant, we beseech thee, that by meditating upon these mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary, of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. And may the divine assistance remain always with us, and may the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love commits me here, ever this night be at our side, to light, to guard, to rule and to guide. Amen. And let's just go into a little moment of silence. Then I'll sing a hymn, and then I'll deliver the message that Our Lady gave me in prayer this evening. And it's a very powerful message. And Satan is attacking through the technology. I can feel it. He's trying to get me annoyed. But he always tries, but Our Lady always keeps me whispering in my ear, telling me what to do. So it's fine. There's no he's just a little mouse compared to Our Lady's dangerous heel. So she'll stamp him out anyway. So Our Lady, do danger with your heel. Stamp out any evil attacking and give us all peace. And may we relax in your immaculate heart and let you console us for a moment in silence. Let these powerful graces from Medjugorje enter your heart and enter your soul. Our Lady really wants to bless you all. She really wants to console. And it's a bit crazy, the technology is a bit funny, but it's fine. It's Bosnia. This happens in Bosnia. And we ask you to bless all the mothers who are worried, and it's a hard time to bring up children. So we ask you to bless all mothers tonight that are watching and that are beyond. And I'm going to sing another song. Just bear with me.
Just when I thought I lost my way.
gave me strength to carry on. That's when I heard you say, I promise you. When your heart is filled with sorrow and despair, footprints in the sand. When I'm weary, well, I know you'll be there. And I can feel you when you say, I promise you, I'm always there. When your heart is filled with sorrow and despair, I'll carry you when you need a friend. You'll find my footprints in the sand. When your heart is filled with sorrow and despair, Jesus will carry you. When you need a friend, you'll find my footprints in the sand. Oh.
Sorry about the technology tonight, it's a bit funny, but it happens. I'm remaining calm. So, earlier today, I was praying to Our Lady, and I'd been to an apparition yesterday. I'll just do the backstory. And it's the monthly message of Mariana, or the annual message from Our Lady to Mariana. And during the apparition, I was praying for peace and praying for my mission. And right at the end of the apparition, there was 12 white doves really high in the sky above Mariana's house where the apparition was. And I tried to capture the doves, but my camera was too crap and they were so high up. But what a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful witness to see those white doves circling over the house. And a lot of people saw it. A lot of people that I met this morning were at the apparition seen it as well. So it was nice that I wasn't the only one who's seen it. And I really felt Our Lady's call deeper and stronger to be a witness for the LGBT souls who are misunderstood, people are afraid of them. People are afraid of this ministry. People have attacked me for this ministry. And I just felt Our Lady really with me and encouraging me and pulling it forward and driving it forward. And a few people who were my enemies at the beginning of this sort of ministry have come to me tonight and get reconciled. So a lot of reconciliation is happening through this apparition. I believe in His graces and a lot of my suffering. So doors are opening. So keep praying for me and keep supporting me, because things are moving and reconciliation is happening. And I just want you to keep me in my prayers. I'll keep you in mind, because this ministry is very delicate. And again, sorry for the interference. So Our Lady is really pushing me, and she's filling me full of courage and full of more peace. And she's healing me more. I'm allowing God into the places where I'm still weak and I'm still bitter and anger. So going to confession and ripping that poison out of my heart, because I'm not perfect either. So here we go. I'm just trying to find the message. It was a very powerful message she gave me as well. So it goes like this when it starts to load. You know, patience is a virtue sometimes, isn't it? My little one, how at times you suffer immensely, for you spend a lot of time being isolated and alone. These are the times where I come and speak with you, and during these moments, you console my aching heart that weeps and laments over this terrible time that humanity has forgotten God and the importance of prayer. Your life is a constant call to more and to give more, and in the end, you will give your life for the faith and a true calling of a prophetic martyr. You are already being martyred by many evil words and deeds. Why do I call you to Medjugorje, my messenger? Your role in my end times has a significant role to play, as you have a very significant role to play in my triumph, my child. Look to me, my children. I use unknown souls, and God chooses various souls to stand out and be lights for the rest of you to be guided. Very soon, very great manifestations will take place in the sky, in nature, and in the earth. The great awakening is upon you. God has to intervene, my children, for you have strayed too far without him. Look around you, there is civil unrest everywhere, and you ask why. Let me tell you as your mother, my children, your hearts cannot and will not rest until they rest in the Creator's. God has made your souls to worship him and love him, so when they do not, they go about seeking worldly delights and worldly pleasures, but nothing can fulfill this search. You, Seamus, went on a destructive path, seeking pleasures of the world, but now, thanks to allowing my hand to intervene and take you back, I am using you, my child, as my example. My children, we are in the end times, the end of this illusion that there is no sin, no God, etc. For the devil himself has deceived you into creating a world without God. You have created a world built on your own arrogance and your own egos. You have created your own Tower of Babel. God will swipe it with his mighty hand, and all these worldly structures that you trust and worship instead of him will topple. The world then will be thrown into utter chaos, and Satan will sift out and devour the weak and sift them out like wheat. One more issue that remains unresolved and brought to God's attention is the issue of my little LGBT flock. Your liberation is at hand, and your Father, your God, is angry and furious at how many of you fight and put up a heavy and merciless resistance to let these souls pass and be made welcome into my son's church. My son left you a commandment: love one another as I have loved you. Love your neighbour as yourself. This is not being carried out. Instead is a blockage and a barricade of insubordinate hearts. Listen, I use this soul and his band of brothers to build a bridge for these souls to cross over, and this bridge will be made for them, and the victory will be mine, for these souls have suffered enough retribution which comes from your hands and your deeds. This will not go away, and these souls will be the rainbow sign of the covenant and testament of complete and total unity under my son's roof in his holy universal church. So, my children, this plan is part of my triumph, and you must change your hearts towards them, for if you can't, then you cannot be called Christian and be expected to take your place at the great banquet prepared for you at the end of time. I have been appearing all over the world, begging you for conversion and to convert your hearts. Here now is a huge block and obstacle that needs removing. I leave you now, children, to examine your hearts, for you all must love God's created. You cannot pick and choose what you do and do not like. God loves all his created children and you. How can you expect to celebrate the triumph of my heart if you're excluding those who in the end will celebrate it most? For the last will be first, and the first will be last. Woe to you who still resist and put up barricades, for you will weep and mourn and lament. Okay, so I'll just go back there. Woe to you who still resist and put up barricades, For you will weep and mourn and lament in God's almighty justice. For your prayer meeting tonight, my child. So she said this was for my prayer meeting tonight. And then she ended the message. So basically, in a nutshell, we're in a very tricky situation in the world today. The world and the governments and schools and all these things have been forcing God out of the picture and replacing it with worldly things like money, greed, power, economic growth, you name it, anything that distracts us from God. That's basically what's in right now, and that's basically what's happened. And God has allowed this to happen, but God is a jealous God, and he wants his people who he created for to love him, and he wants his people who he created to be one, to be united. But he also wants his people to pray to him and to ask them to heal them and let him be part of their lives. Because if God's at the center of our lives, we want for nothing. And with my life, the way I live, I've given God everything because God's asked me to live in divine providence. God has asked me to live completely in his trust and to be attached to only him, not to be attached to a place, not to be attached to worldly structures, worldly things, politics, etc., etc., but to just be attached to Mother here and attached to God. And when you're attached completely to God, which I'm mortifying, then you won't be relying on the economy, the news, what's new, what's hip, what's da-da-da-da-da. Okay, these things have their place. But if God is in the first place, then you'll want for nothing. And then when these things that God is allowing to happen through nature, through manifestations in the sky, through various apparitions that are calling us back to him, he's giving us signposts. So when we have developed a relationship with God, when we have God at the center and we're living a life with Mass, with confession, with the sacraments, we're enriched, we're strong, and we have a strong foundation. We're like a tree that has strong roots, so then nothing can shake us, no matter if the world is falling around us, there's asteroids falling from the sky, there's fire all over. We will not be panicked, we will not be afraid, because we know that our God is with us and that he's protecting us. And Our Lady's chosen me to help and educate people on the end times, which is what's happening now. And we're about to go into a very delicate tribulation, which is going to be tough. But part of Our Lady's triumph and part of Our Lady's heart winning and for her to bring unity to the church is the LGBT community, who have suffered immensely, who have been misunderstood, who have been despised, been marginalised, been ridiculed, been knocked down. And like, if you look at it, there's so many gay suicides right now in the world, trans suicides, transphobia, homophobia. And every time I mention what I'm doing in the church, I get pushed down, I get dirty looks, I get ostracized and pushed aside. And it's very difficult. And Our Lady sees the need, even Pope Francis sees the need. And we're in an emergency. There's so many young souls out there that are transgender, that are gay, and that have been so abused and marginalized and spiritually bullied and you name it, they got it. And they're still hurting in their wounds. And the media shows you that, oh, gay marriage is accepted and everything's okay, but there's still a lot of wounds that are inside the gay community that need to be healed. And only God can heal those wounds. And God wants to build a relationship with these LGBT people, LGBT souls. That's why he's put it in my heart. And if you look at things in God's perspective, every time I mention stuff in Medjugorje about what I'm doing, a lot of people will support it, but I get a lot of gossip and a lot of slander and a lot of evil looks because I mention the word LGBT, and they automatically shame me and try to put me down. But these people don't realise, and they probably mean the best from their hearts. They're not evil people, but they're just miseducated. And that's why God's using me to re-educate. And these people are blocking these souls from entering. And these souls have a calling from God as well. These souls have a calling to become holy and to become perfect like the rest of us. And if people are blocking the church like policemen and saying, oh, you need to change your ways before you can enter. Well, no one told that heterosexual person that they needed to change their ways before they could enter or could receive communion. The Eucharist isn't a prize for the just, it's a prize for the weak and a prize for the sinner. And we're all sinners, we're all equal, we're all equally loved by God. And God has had enough. God is really angry at how many people police the church and treat it like a checkpoint where people enter and where people can't enter. And they've turned the church into an exclusive club. But the word Catholic means universal, everyone welcome. It's not exclusive. And Jesus wants his church to be inclusive. And Our Lady even said yesterday that she wants all her children to be united in her message. And that's what God wants. God wants unity. God wants community. And when we receive the Eucharist, we have communion. We are in communion with God. So the word communion means the word communion is communion, yes. But when we receive communion, we become community. We become transformed. We become a community in unity with Jesus. And then we have the power to go out. And then when we go out, we evangelize. And there's a need to evangelize these souls because these souls are all stuck in addictions of all sorts. And these souls need to know they're loved, need to know that they're loved by God. And I'll give you an example. When I'm working here on the ground in Medjugorje in the past, I've met many women who are aunts, who are mothers. And when I tell them what I'm doing, and what Our Lady has put in my heart and what God has put in my heart, they rejoice and say, this is really needed. This is the news I've been waiting for, because my son is suicidal. He's broken and he's depressed and he's addicted to pornography. He's addicted to sex and addicted to promiscuous sex. And when I tell these women and these families that there's a place for them in the church and that God is paving a way and he's using us to build a bridge to bring these souls into the church where they can be integrated and made feel welcome and to begin a path to holiness. And look, I'm not the best. I'm still a work in progress. But God has given me a path. God has given me a pathway. And the thing is, there's only 2% of these stories whenever gay people get changed, in inverted commas. Those people weren't really gay to begin with because they were just curious. So Our Lady's educated me on this. And she said to me, 99.9% of people that are gay are gay. And their sexuality cannot change. But through the sacraments and through a path of holiness, they're an apple and the part of them is bad, but whenever they go to confession, go to mass, go to receive the sacraments and live in a community where they're supported and they can talk out things where they're struggling with, then that apple becomes a good apple and that bad part of the apple, that is the lust, is destroyed and it becomes holier and it becomes a better vessel and a better vessel to worship and love Christ and love their neighbor. And this is not going against church teachings. This is actually incorporating the catechism, and it's living out the catechism and the church teachings in a holy, tangible and realistic way. And it's a pastoral approach, and the Pope at the moment is hitting on the same things that our Medjugorje LGBT ministry has been saying for the past 5 years. So praise be Jesus. Praise be Our Lady. Thank you for our mother for appearing in Medjugorje. Thank you for our mother for enlightening us and allowing me and choosing me to educate people on the LGBT issue, but also to help encourage people, to encourage gay people to come back to the church, and that there is an approach to holiness for gay people, and they can be in relationships with one another, and they can be in loving, healthy relationships with each other, intimate relationships with each other, holy relationships with each other. But when they have Christ Jesus at the centre and they're living a sacramental life, they can live purity and chastity as best they can because they're in a community that is achieving and aiming for the same goal. So praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And thank you for listening. And that is basically what Our Lady is pushing in my life, pushing in our ministry. And it won't go away, but it's being dealt with. And bit by bit, we're hammering through the bridge and we're building the bridge. And it's thanks to people like you on the ground here that are watching and supporting me and have been supporting me all along, especially my mother, who I love, and my family, who I love. Thank you so much. And thank you for my Belfast crew. Thank you for people in Cull Ireland that have supported me. And we'll go out on a high. We'll go out with a hymn. And let me just choose one. Since it's Mother's Day, I'll sing another Our Lady hymn on the way out. So bear with me a second. I'll find a hymn. And sorry for the technology tonight. It's been a bit funny. And join in if you know the words.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Star, so strong and bright, gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You are chosen for the Son. You were chosen from a women and for teach us wisdom, teach us love. Teach us wisdom, teach us love, teach us love, teach us wisdom, teach us love.
Thank you for watching, and the technology was a bit funny, but we got there in the end. And thank you to our Holy Mother on this Mother's Day for wrapping her mantle around us, for appearing to us in these times, for teaching us in these times, because we're in a battle between the principalities of darkness and Satan. But in the end, Our Lady's heart will triumph, and there will be peace, and peace will reign in men's hearts, and God will be the ruler of mankind again, and there will be peace like never before when we cross over to when we cross over to the new spring with the new springtime, which is coming very soon. So good night, God bless, and may Our Lady keep you safe, and may her angels surround you and your homes, and may she give all these special mothers out there a special